This video tutorial I will explain using a RESTful web service how to create an employee, how to update an employee, how to get an employee, and how to delete an employee. Here I have defined the class Employee Service Controller, which is a REST controller, and it has a create employee method. To call this method, we have to send request to this path, and method is post. This method accept employee object, and it has update employee method. To call this method, we have to send request to this path. Here id is the path variable, and method is put, and this method accept id and the employee object. And it has a get employee method. To call this method, we have to send request to this path, and method is get, and this method accept id, and it has a get employees method. To call this method, we have to send request to this path, and method is get, and it has a delete employee method. To call this method, we have to send request to this path, and method is delete, and this method accept id. Here you can see employee table, and it does not have any records. Here you can see the application class, which is Spring Boot application. I am starting this Spring Boot application in debug mode. Spring Boot application is started in 8080 port. First, I am going to send employee create request. URL is this one, and method is post. And body we have to choose raw type and JSON. And here I am sending the employee object in JSON format. Name is Peter, age is 45, salary is 90,000. I am sending the request. Employee is created successfully with the primary key 6. And here you can see, one employee record is created. Next, I will send update request. I am adding the ID as 6 and method as put, and changing the age to 65 and salary to 10,000. Sending the request. And here you can see employee is updated successfully, and here you can see age is changed to 65 and salary is changed to 10,000. Next, I will send get request. Change the method to get. Send the request. And here we got the employee object in JSON format. Next, I will send delete request. Send. Employee is deleted successfully. Refresh. And here you can see the employee record is deleted. Again, I am sending the same request. The employee record is not there in the database, so it throws employee not found exception. And that exception is handled here. and we got employee not found. Next, I will create two more employee records. Next, I will get all the employees from the employee table. Select get and send the request. And here we got the output. We got array of employee objects in JSON format. There are two records in the database. We got two records here. You can get Java source code link from the description of the video. In mobile, to see the description, click on this icon. It will expand like this, and here you can see the description. It contains Java source code links. Click on these links to get the Java source code.